Congratulations.
No, I put my work in the ring, though, in the gym. I did that for sure. Thank you.
Oh, congratulations.
Man, what's going on, man? Thank you. Appreciate it, man.
Yo, what's up, man?
What's up with what?
What's up, me and you, man?
I would love to. I'll fight anyone.
Negotiations?
Trust me. I fear no man. I'll fight anybody, but I respect you, man. I have much respect for you, man. Much respect. For real. Let's do it. If you can do it, I'll do it.
I like you winning that. You know, it's a competitive game.
Thank you, man.
What are your thoughts on tonight's fight?
I called it. I had interviews prior to coming to this fight, and I called it. I already knew what was going to happen. I kind of felt sorry for Seth. I knew it was going to happen. That early, I didn't know it was going to happen that early also. I already knew that.
I thought you were leasing 2-3 rounds.
Hey,
nah, it wasn't 2-3 rounds.
That was the nicest, most politest way that someone ever called you out to your face.
I respect that, though. I respect him because he's a true fighter, man. He's proven his mark. He's proven himself.
I also didn't want to walk up on him like this and cut your elbow.
He did it the hard way, so I respect someone like that, man.
Can it happen?
Of course it could happen. Why wouldn't it? It's boxing, man. This is boxing.
Remember when you heard it first?
Like I said, man. First, let me grab my title. But if this happens before that, I'm all for it, man. I'm all for it. I'm a warrior in the ring, in and out. Got my boy right there, Latif.
Good job.
How you been, man?
Can you translate for me when I interview him?
Huh?
Translate?
Oh, yeah. You want to do, you fight over here, you throw punches. You know?
It's my boy Latif, boy.
Latif, how you feeling?
I'm feeling good.
After a title shot.
You know what? Honestly, it's probably going to happen between me and Severn because he's number one, I'm number two. Doesn't look like Klitschko's going to come back. And if that fight happens, I would love for that fight to happen, man.
I want to avenge my loss with him, man.
But if this happens with this man, why not? Let's make it happen. I fear no man, and I know it'll be a good fight because he's a quality fighter.
Where's Seth Mitchell go from here?
You know what? I could try to pull some strings, get him a try with the Raiders or maybe the LA Avengers. You never know. But MMA is pretty good for him. It looks like he's a strong guy. He do pretty good in MMA.
Chris, always a pleasure. Thank you so much.
Thank you, bro.
What about a lot of people talking Deontay Wilder? What do you think about that? Your hand?
You know, Deontay Wilder needs to prove, just like he has, he needs to fight quality fighters. You know, no disrespect to Lajovic, but he's pretty much done.
I made him done. I finished him.
Yeah.
Last March.
So, he needs to prove himself. You know, in my come up, I fought quality fighters like Bolo Wills, Malcolm Tan, Witherspoon. All of them were up-and-coming fighters. Oh, can't forget Travis Walker. He was up-and-coming. He was a tough dude, so I made my mark.
And now, what goes through your mind? You're still fired up.
Oh, no, man. I'm ready to get a drunk, to be honest with you. I'm not going to lie to you, man. I'm ready to drink. It's been 6 weeks since no drinking, no smoking, no nothing. So I'm ready to have a good time.
Any message to your fans, Chris, right now?
Hey, thank you for everybody out there, man. You know, stay up. Keep watching, man. I did all for my fans, for everybody that supported me, everyone that's out there, man.
Did you see any other fights tonight? Or you
nah, man. I was just too busy in my room, just, you know, had my mindset going.
Did you see some of the fights tonight, the knockouts?
Yeah, I seen the
describe the Rafael Marquez got knocked out in the ninth round.
Yeah, that was he lost the first three rounds, but after that he started picking up and the other guys just start going downhill. So it was definitely a good fight.
So you guys are gonna go to Vegas this weekend?
I don't know. I gotta check with Jay Prince and see what's up. You know, see if I can go over there and
Jay Prince is a good dude, just by the way. Yeah. Jay Prince is a quality dude.
You already know.
Prince takes care of Houston. Like I got it on lock.
There you have it, Chris Arreola. You called him out. How does it feel?
I feel good.
And he was
feel good. I get to keep my guns tucked.
He was planning the whole time. Was that the plan the whole time?
Yeah. You know, I was kind of skeptical about how to do it. Yeah, because I'm still respectful individual. And I don't want to get locked up out here in Palm Springs. So, but you know, I do it the right way. You know, let him know straight from the gate, as long as he understand. No matter how I do it, as long as he understand. That was good that I did it a good way, and he understands. So we already know what it is. You know what it is. He standing right there. You know, take Instagram pictures. Look.
If it's not Chris, who would you want?
I don't even know, man, because I had my mind. I just ain't got finished answering that question. I had my mind set on the Adamic fight. You know, once they announced it to me, you know, I just had my mind focused on it. So right now, I have nobody else. Probably Arreola now. That all that momentum shifts. You get what I'm saying? I'm hopping on train to train. You already know. I need to fight. Last year I fought 5 times and tried to blame it on my manager, saying that I didn't fight because of my manager. Like, no. Like, what I need to do is get a fair deal. Yo, I need to get some things straightened out. I'm not no guy that's just gonna be saying yes, 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 yes. You know what I mean? I need to be treated with some respect. So.
Can I guess this? Why boxing? You're in a division where one punch could end a fight, and as we see.
Boxing so easy. I started 4 years ago, January 2009, man. I walked into the gym and I exceeded expectations so far that there was no way I could turn back. There's no way I could turn back.
Very few people started that late, like yourself, Sergio Martinez, but you're excelling. He's excelling. Tell me about that. How are you so successful starting this late?
Because I already had focus. I already had focus as a man. You know, when the way I came up, you know, nobody else can even imagine coming up that way. You know, I have militant abilities. I have disciplinary acts to where as though I would get out there on the road and I would usually run 15 miles anyway before boxing. They'd be like, why do I run? Why do I do push-ups? Why do I stay in shape? You know, why do I want to look fit? Why do I want to do this? Why am I so ambitious? It's just in me. I'm God's gift, so I'm here. So
and now it's going well.
And now it's going well. You know, this boxing thing is here. So I mean, come on.
It came easy to you.
Yeah, it definitely came easy to me. You know, I was in the streets doing, you know, doing things that I wasn't supposed to be doing. So it's like, all right, why not make money doing it? So
let me ask you, who's the toughest guy you ever sparred?
Toughest guy I ever sparred? It probably would be a lighter guy. But all my sparring is pretty much, I make it easy.
Lighter guys is faster.
I make it easy. Yeah, the lighter guy is faster. My man Beast, his first name Mike, but I forget his last name. But yo, he always give good work because yo, he's a younger guy. He's still an amateur. So as we spar, I teach him, and you know whenever we spar, and he do it, and it works. Cause I'm always teaching people that sparring, you know, whatever works on me, I want you to do, so I can learn, you know, to avoid it. So he learns well, he works well, and he's somebody to be looking out for.
Starting the big names?
No, when I first got in the game, Chaz was I scored Kevin Johnson. Not too many big names. I used to two people at a time to equal up to one person. So they put two heavyweights in there at one time, and then that's one person.
There you have it. Stay tuned all the way from North Philly, EsNewsReporting.com, and Melissa Crack reporting. You know, I thought you were gonna go in his face and start screaming and doing like the whole like nose to nose.
Nah, man. I was told not to get no man face now unless you're ready to swing a punch or get punched. You get what I'm saying? So that's something that you really can't do.
Yeah, you got class. That was nice.
Don't expect me to get in nobody face. But I'm my hands balled up already. It's whatever. You mean, but you know not to go in no man face, you know, and not to get hit or hit.
Fuck that. I ain't doing that.